The way bricks are made in South Asia is a very important environmental and health problem. If we look at the amount of radiative forcing from the exhaust from brick kilns, it creates as much radiative force as the greenhouse gas from the entire US passenger car fleet. I was actually flying in an airplane over India, and I looked down and I saw a brick kiln. So then I got thinking, well, wait a minute, if I can do this sitting in a plane, we must be able by remote satellite to detect these as well. And so started to work to see if we could in fact map all the brick kilns across Bangladesh.
In 2015, the European Space Agency launched their Sentinel-2A satellite. Now, this satellite is a multispectral imager, which means it captures data in a lot of bands. Right from the visible band, which we are able to see, up to the infrared, which is basically where the heat signatures lie. We decided to use the Sentinel-2A images for our project. Steve had a ground team which actually went about and collected the GPS locations of a few of the kilns, and they gave them to me. I used this data to develop a model about what a kiln looks like versus what a kiln does not look like. And as expected, most of the data required for separating the two lay in the infrared region. Our algorithm actually detects these kilns very well. In fact, in the small district we were looking at, it found brick kilns which the ground team did not find during their data collection. What makes this really cool is that we are actually able to find these needles in a haystack very, very accurately.
We are working with kiln owners and a leading consultant group in India, Green Tech, that has developed interventions which both improve kiln efficiency and reduce pollution. This is important because this way kiln owners who adopt this not only have less polluting kilns, but they also save money because they don't have to buy so much coal. Ultimately, we foresee consolidating all of this information onto a website that is available to all of the people in Bangladesh and use this as a platform to get a message out. And the message is, where are the brick kilns? What can we do to improve these brick kilns? And how can we help catalyze that process? We think that the approaches we're using will be adaptable not only to Bangladesh, but across all of South Asia.